Remember this, like, from 4 months ago when I went to Toronto Game Expo and then I asked everyone if they've ever heard of Naraka? I hired 2 cosplayers using partnership money, and the results then back then kind of spoke for themselves, especially when the game wasn't free to play. But, you know, things have changed quite a bit since, right? Now, you know, I had the whole fighting game community involved. And you can actually see that the Viper and the 2B cosplayer are actually on the Toronto Video Game Expo website in the cosplay section. So they are now permanently there. And it's great because now with the Nier collab out, it even means more. And not so long after this con, I think 4 months down after, I think about a month ago, I ran the first North American LAN at Invictus Game Station, and was able to fill up the place quite a bit with, you know, mostly Naraka players. It was supposed to be a Naraka and ex-League of Legends social, because I wasn't sure how many people in Toronto were going to show up for specifically Naraka, but quite a bit did. I did have League of Legends cosplayers there as well. Was able to cast to a viewership of around 5,000 people. Alongside Awake on Twitch, and we ran a $1,000 tournament, which was great. We had great turnout and a lot of players, and we had a Kurumi and Viper cosplayer that were also there, and which was fantastic. And you know, me and Big Red Beard were co-casting alongside Awake, and we also had the League of Legends cosplayers, the Kurumi and the Viper, there at Invictus Game Station. And we did a lot of photos of that. And we'll be posting those soon. And yeah, they were there playing Naraka while in cosplay. Now, I saw the Gamescom announcement that they had a full-on booth there. And I was very excited of that. They were giving away PS5s. I didn't remember exactly how that system worked. But yeah, that was amazing. And they got a lot of peripheral type of like setup. And also the whole display was amazing. You know, they had the 2B cosplayer at the Viper name cosplayer in front of the stage, essentially, of the booth. And then they had the great sword and also like all the references to Nier, like the flowers and all that type of stuff. And that was fantastic. And then all people had to do was, like, I think they had to take photos with the cosplayers, and then, obviously the 2B cosplayer had the white flower, and then Viper Ning had the soul bloom in hand. And that's just, like, cosplayers are one of the best form of marketing, because a lot of people want to take photos with the cosplayers, they post photos with the cosplayers, and people ask, oh, where's that cosplay from, what is that game, all that kind of stuff, what's that cosplayer is at, right? I have an older gentleman here sitting on the front of the display here. You know, you're never too old for games, you know. And it was great. Like, the whole display was really great. They also showcased, like, other NetEase published games. They also gave away Naraka merchandise, like this kind of, I think it's like an acrylic charm thing. You can spin, I think it is, in the middle. Here you have Viper Ning, the cosplayer. doing some swordplay in front of the, I think it's very hard to see with the blindfold on, unfortunately. I think that's why they're looking up so much, but you know, that's pretty cool. And then here we have, I think, what is it here? The booth, yeah. So side, you can see that people are playing on PS5 controllers. You can see them playing on keyboard and mouse, right? With the PS5 release, and then everyone's just trying to game out. And then, yeah, they walked by the Honkai Star Rail booth as cosplayers. And then it's funny because you had people pointing at these other cosplayers that walked by from the HSR side of things. And yeah, I think overall it was a huge success at Gamescom, and I really want to see more of this, more cosplayers at these events. All these booths at conventions, anime conventions, and gaming conventions, because the marketing for it is incredible. Yeah, so come out to Canada, if anything. I'm here.